So this is the start of our Meridian location. This is the front office here in our lobby, and this is where patients come check in. I want to show you, Paulette, kind of what we're doing that I think is a little bit unique. So on this side, on this side of the building, we've got our primary care practitioners, and then we've got our pediatrician. And then on this side over here is our women's health section. Wonderful. So I think what we're offering is pretty unique and special in that we've got all life care, right? We've got our women's health team, both a midwife and an OB-GYN physician that offers kind of for natural fertility options, optimizing prenatal care. Yes. And then it's actually been really cool to be able to see our women's health team hand the baby off to the pediatrician, right? And just focus on that early intervention with nutrition and lifestyle. And then we see the parents, and then eventually when they turn 17, 18 years old, family practitioners come on and see the adult patients. So it's really unique. Yeah, so let's
That's
head
beautiful.
On. Yeah, we love it. So we'll walk on back here and kind of show you what else is going on behind the scenes. So right back here is where our nutritionist, at least at the Meridian location, does nutritional consults. Mm-hmm. So we do one-on-one nutrition consults, but I'll be honest, the majority of what we've turned our nutritional team into is offering shared medical visits. Mm-hmm. So here we do what we call our small group shared medical visits. So a lot of our patients come in and we offer right off the bat an elimination diet. And so instead of our nutritionist seeing 30 people that week and saying the same thing about an elimination diet, she can see a small group of four or five individuals, answer their questions, be in a community setting, and going through what our comprehensive elimination diet looks like.
So that's what does that look really like for any given person? Say I'm going to come in because I'm huge on nutritional health.
Yeah, I love it.
So if I'm coming in, what would you tell me right off the bat? I mean, how does that proceed?
Yeah, so we offer a lot of handouts and education and meal planning ideas and resources, but we're really trying to encourage people to cook and make their meals and sometimes grow their own food.
Right? Perfect in the time of COVID.
Yes, absolutely. You don't have to go to the grocery store. Yeah, and they have time. Yeah, it's actually been a really great time to teach people these things. But a lot of it is trying to hone in on foods that are driving inflammation in the body. Mm. So we're pulling out gluten, wheat, of course, sugar, sometimes dairy, even eggs or corn, foods that aren't inherently necessarily bad, but that the body might be reacting to. So you pull the foods out for a given period of time. Usually it's 3 weeks to get those initial antibodies down. And then the nutritionist will guide them in how to reintroduce those foods one at a time. Yeah. One of the biggest things I think this team does, and they do it well, is to learn to read labels. Because a lot of times sugar, high fructose corn syrup, gluten or wheat can be hidden in the foods. Mm. So until you pull it out, you can't get those antibodies down, and it kind of defeats the purpose of being able to do an elimination diet. So
yeah, I look at this as where functional medicine really starts, because it comes down to the ground point of nutritional health and the foods you put in your body.
Yeah. So if you're able to grow, how your body reacts to those foods, right?
Yes, and all the foods that exactly what what you're putting into your system, I think that's perfect. So this to me is where it all starts.
Yeah, so part of our new patient process is that every patient, before they even see me for the second time, they come here, right? Either virtually right now, a lot of our visits are being done virtually right now with our nutritionist, but when they can get together and socially distance and be in one space, we're really offering the community feel too, where I think there's a lot that can be brought in. Cleveland Clinic's done a ton of work where they've seen improved outcomes through people being in community and sharing their struggles and saying, oh, it's been so hard to cut sugar from my diet and stop drinking pop. How's it been for you? And so that offers a really cool time where everyone can get together and communicate about those things.
Oh yeah. Well, now there's clear data to support, you know, the fact that nutritional health is critical to your healthcare. So
again, during a pandemic, right? Now's the time, and that's where it's been interesting. Initially, we didn't have a lot of people coming into the clinic back in February when this hit, but it only took a few weeks and we were able to pivot and really educate. Now's the time you should be seeing your nutritionist more than ever, right? Now's the time we have to get that inflammation down and get the sugar out of the diet.
Exactly.
So they've been slammed. We've been able to hire another nutritionist through this pandemic because we've been so busy with our nutritional work.
Oh, good. And is it covered under insurance or are the insurers including? Okay, because that's huge. Because
great question.
We spend trillions of dollars, you know, in government funding to address people's chronic illnesses. Now, I imagine you see all kinds of great stories where people coming through and they're able to cure certain diseases like their diabetes and cancer. I've met so many people who tell me wonderful stories about just changing their diet and then being able to get off these, you know, certain pharmaceuticals.
Oh, we can heal type 2 diabetes within 2 days of changing people's lifestyles. Yeah. I mean, it's amazing.
It is amazing.
So it's been pretty cool. Yeah. So I actually started in the field of rheumatology and treating a lot of autoimmune diseases. And I've always been really passionate about nutrition. I was that little girl that was eating salads when everyone else was eating goldfish and crackers. And so it's always been something that I've educated my patients on, mostly through my own self-directed learning and education. But especially within the field of rheumatology, it was just incredible to see them being able to come off their steroids and come off a lot of their medications, and their pain started to decrease, and they started to, you know, I mean, the hospital didn't love it, but they started to be able to go longer between their visits with me because they didn't need to see me as often because their symptoms were so much more well controlled. So again, this is where we shine, food first. That's really what we offer.
So being your background, your field, your expertise, now do you ever see people in local hospitals or clinics working to partner in with you? Because we're not only talking about a huge cost savings for individual patients, but I mean, I would imagine the cost savings for hospitals and clinics as well.
Yeah. The two major hospitals here in our community are starting to develop lifestyle medicine programs. And I actually had a hospitalist call me last week saying, I want to come in. I want to meet you guys. I want to meet your medical director. I'd love to shadow you and see what you guys are doing. She said, this is the future of healthcare. And I've seen it now more than ever amidst a pandemic that we have to go this direction. And she said, a lot of my colleagues internationally are seeking functional medicine. They want to do functional medicine fellowships. So I need to learn, you know, she really turned to us and said, you guys are the local clinic that I know is doing it and doing it right and doing it in an offer that people can afford. And so, yeah, she's, so that's a perfect example. So I think where we have to bridge that gap is there's lifestyle medicine and there's integrative medicine and then there's functional medicine, true root cause medicine. It takes training, it takes education, it takes, it's just a paradigm shift on how we approach the human body and how we approach chronic disease. So that's where we have to really bridge that gap and get people trained in the right way, right? So
for those naysayers who are out there who might think, yeah, you know, functional medicine, changing my diet, that's gonna be really hard.
Yeah.
What are some of the challenges that you see with folks coming in who are doubtful? And then where's the point that clicks for them? And then the light bulb comes on and then they're able to see the effectiveness.
You know, everybody's unique. And part of how we're trained in functional medicine is to meet people where they're at. And sometimes that's not telling people, come do our comprehensive elimination diet. That's hard. Because people that have never been in the kitchen and never had to prepare their own meal because they're used to running through McDonald's or running to the gas station and grabbing food, right? So maybe it's not always telling someone, you have to meet with my nutritionist and go through a comprehensive elimination diet. Maybe it's telling somebody to start calculating how much sugar they're consuming. You know, and so people stop eating that much sugar, or stop drinking Coke, or stop eating fast food or excess processed food. That can make all the difference in the world for that person. And all of a sudden the fog is lifted and all of a sudden they have energy and they're motivated to go for a walk outside and they're motivated to want to make something healthy because they start to become in tune with their body and they realize how much better they can feel. I think that's where we're really limited with a lot of people. They don't realize how good they can feel because they grew up in a home where they're eating fast food or they're eating a lot of white carbohydrates, right, that have no nutritional value. And so I think a lot of what our goal is with patients is to just get in tune with their body, kind of like we talked about earlier, and again, meet them where they're at and not overwhelm them with the kind of changes we want them to make, but just start to make them more aware of what they're putting in their body or the kind of air they're breathing, or just educate them on gut health and the immune system and how 70% of your immune system lives in your gut. Right? That's really important for people to know during a pandemic.
Absolutely.
So that's, you know, we have to start at different places with each patient. Some people are moving from California to Idaho and they've been seeing a naturopath and so they're aware and they know a lot of these concepts and we can kick that bar farther along with those people. And other people, it's starting with basics like drinking enough water, you know, starting to replace your coffee with water in the morning and throughout the day. And again, that can be a really big interval change for individuals.
Yeah, exactly. I see some cultural shifts too. Mm-hmm. You know, people going from this very fast lifestyle, you know, drive through foods, and then of course people wanting to eat, you know, their instant food that they get out of a microwave and sit down in front of a TV versus sitting with their family and enjoying
sharing
their food and
breathing in between
having
their meals,
a positive relationship with their food. Yeah, so I see a huge difference, but you know, I'm thankful that you see the way and you're helping guide people to build that relationship.
I hope so. Yeah, you bring up a good point. Sometimes it's more than just what food we're putting into our body. Sometimes it's, are we actually sitting down and saying a prayer, breathing before a meal, preparing our bodies to eat, right? So our nutritionists also focus on the concept of eating hygiene, right? Preparing the digestive system to absorb the nutrients from food and being able to break down the food instead of eating in your car when your body's not really ready to absorb nutrients and digest food.
So. Well, my grandparents, they lived very long lives, and one of my grandfathers, they said, lived well over 150 years. This was generations ago.
Yeah.
But our people, we would pray over our food.
I love it.
And just the whole ceremony is honoring the food, praying over the food, being grateful, and then sharing in that process with the entire community or family. So I think that relationship was so positive and beautiful. It also indicated the health of our lifestyle because we respected our food.
Yeah, and when you bring in gratitude and practice what you're thankful for, it's a mind shift, right? It shifts your mind from focusing on the negative, especially within our crazy world right now.
So, exactly.
Yeah, that's something we teach a lot too. So let's head over onto, I just wanted to kind of show a glimpse of what also is happening back here. This is our pediatric department. So kiddos come here, they get really good care early on in life. So, and then back hallway is our family medicine practitioner. So adult medicine, pediatrics, this is kind of what we do back here.
So with pediatrics, what are some of the practices here? This is really cute. I love all
that. Isn't that fun? Yeah, Dr. Bruce is great.
Well, in pediatrics, what's the relationship like with children?
As far as?
When you're bringing functional medicine with youth. For my son, for example, you know, I want to get more chiropractic care into his life. Yeah. And, you know, he's got growing pain, so it's nice to have a chiropractor available to help with that. And, of course, it's everything, you know, with mobility. So are there certain types of care that are offered here?
No, we don't do chiropractic care here at Pediatricians and MD, but we have those relationships all throughout the community where we have the chiropractors we send our kiddos to, and same, all of us really, truly, you know, energy healers.
Yes.
We have a lot of those really good relationships we build in the community, people we trust and know, and also that encourage and understand what we do, right? Okay. So we can work with each other to really continue to encourage our patients to make these changes and make improvements.
Great. So you serve as not just an educational center, but resource center, and you're able to give recommendations for people to go.
Yeah, holistic integrative dentistry, like I said, energy healing, physical therapy, sleep specialists. We have good relationships with individuals in our community that, again, understand what we do. If I'm going to send somebody to an endocrinologist or Dr. Bruce is going to send somebody to a pediatric cardiologist, they have to look at a list of supplements and understand why this patient might not be on a lot of medications that another kiddo coming in might be on. And they have to understand that these kind of things are important and that food matters, that food can cure disease, right? So we've developed a group of subspecialists that understand and at least encourage what we do and not discourage it.
You know, something interesting is I met with a Sundance leader, and you know, our people are very based around ceremony in our culture. And she said to me, you know, it's funny because really all we need to find is the right plant. That is the antidote, because you see all the animals and all of our relatives in that world are not dying off. They're immune, but it's because of a plant. She said, we just have to find the right plan. But I think we're going down the right path. So this is why I really lean in on functional medicine, because, you know, it really is about the right foods to be the antidote. If there's ever going to be a vaccination, it's really more, you know, your own personal nutrition.
Right.
So if whatever you're able to implement with our young students, because the kids, you know, if they're eating the junk foods of today, which is, you know, and most markets are treated kind of like a quick mart where it's just a quick stop.
Right.
And there's, you know, so many chemicals in our foods today, and our kids are attracted to the commercials or whatever they see, the brightly colored design, and, you know, because marketing is so strong.
So strong towards these kids,
So there's just a lot of work needing to be done at a young age to educate them to eat the foods that don't seem as fun, you know, the foods that we grow.
Right.
versus what's produced.
Yeah, so Dr. Bruce and his team, they're really good at, of course, encouraging the kid to do that, but so much of it is parent education. Mm-hmm. So what he does really well is he also encourages the parent and the family to come and see us. Because if the parent is educated and they're on the same page and they're encouraged to put the right foods and right herbs and supplements in their body, the child will follow, right? You have to lead by example. Mm-hmm. So he's really good at making sure the parent gets into our practice and they're integrated with what we're teaching. Dr. Bruce is also really good at teaching and educating on, like you mentioned, chemicals in our environment. He educates on EMFs, getting kids off the screens, turning off Wi-Fi at night, things like that that can activate their brains and are hard on their mitochondria and hard on their gut health as well.
Yeah. Oh, if we only had commercials to educate our children on Wi-Fi.
Yes. Oh, I know.
And technology.
Exactly. Well, like the kids all going to online school, right? Nobody's talking about what that's going to do to brain development and overstimulation and anxiety and angst in these children. No one's talking about that. And that really worries us as an organization of educators.
Do you see a rise in our young people being impacted by technology in all these different ways with ADHD?
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. He's got incredible stories of families coming in telling testimonies of kiddos. He tells the parents, let's unplug the Wi-Fi and turn the screens off. And within 48 hours, sometimes overnight, the anger comes down, the anxiety comes down, the behavior improves. He's talking about kids as young as 2 and 3 years old where he sees overnight changes with some really simple fixes.
Yeah, I believe it.
Yeah, it's neat. All right, so let's head on over this way.
Yeah, I have a 10-year-old and he is constantly wanting to be on his phone or his iPad.
Aren't they all? That's all they see. It's what they're modeled.
Yeah.
It's really hard. I know my kindergartner is doing online school. We actually formed a co-op, but I just got an email saying,
great.
Send your kindergartner in to pick up their iPad. I'm like, he's 5. There's no way I'm going to put him in an iPad to learn for 4 hours a day, right? Oh,
that's so rough, yeah.
So we do women's health over here, but kind of this admin room is, I think, really important. This is where our team makes that initial contact with new patients. So a new patient signs up online, fills out their paperwork, and they get a call from our patient care navigator. And so Taylor here explains kind of the process, what we do. Our new patient process is very similar for each patient. They discuss with the patient care navigator, and then next they meet with our health coach. Usually it's a phone call, not in person. Kind of where they really establish their readiness. How ready are they? That helps me know, is this patient ready to do a comprehensive elimination diet? Is this patient ready to spend $500 on a specialized functional medicine test where I can analyze nutrient deficiencies? Or do we have to take a step back and start, you know, more with some foundations like sleep and just stress management and being aware of toxicities in our environment. So what this team really does is help us know where to start and really know where we need to focus on, what their health goals are. If a patient can't get out of bed in the morning because they're so tired, I have to start there. I have to know that that's this patient's most important goal before I can really encourage them to do other things. So.
That's the beauty really of functional medicine, I think, just really getting to the heart of it. No drugs. Yeah.
Right.
You're not sending them an expensive health care bill.
Right.
Yeah. You really want to address the root of it.
Yeah. And that's where this team also kind of explains to the patient our policy on narcotic refills and our policy on things like that, because we have some pretty hardcore policies and protocols to really encourage patients to want to come off those kind of medications and really figure out root cause so that they're not bound to those. So these visits are actually complimentary. It's just kind of part of we do have membership options, but it's just, we felt like this piece was so important because I don't have to assess their readiness and I don't have to take the time to figure out their health goals. I know them the night before when I'm going through their paperwork and prepping their chart and prepping for my appointment with them. I really know where they're at. So it saves me, 15 to 25% of my work is done because of this team.
Yeah.
So it's something we've implemented in the past 6 months, and it's been pretty revolutionary for the kind of care we're offering.
Yeah, that's huge. So have you offered this as a model to other functional medicine facilities around the country, as James has said?
That's our plan. We haven't done it yet, but our plan is to really be able to bring clinicians and administrators in and teach and train what we're doing and what we found successful. But this is still pretty new for us, so we're still kind of working out the kinks as far as what that looks like and really still trying to make sure that being able to offer it complimentary is a good business model. So far it looks like it is because it's so popular. And I think, you know, it's so unique. Most people have never heard of something like this, where you get a free call from somebody from the clinic talking about what we do and what we offer. And then the next day you get a call from a certified health coach asking about your health goals. Right. And you haven't been charged yet. And then that's before you even get to see the practitioner. And so I think that's, we have people that complain about the paperwork they have to fill out to come see it, because it's about 12 to, before they come see us, it's about 12 to 13 pages of some pretty in-depth analysis on your past medical history and your history, you know, even starting from when you were born. But it allows me to know a lot about that patient before I walk in and introduce myself and shake their hand. So I think most people really appreciate that kind of care and that kind of time we spend.
I would tell you, I would appreciate that thoroughness, and it does make it more effective. And of course, there's a good trust being established. I would definitely trust you coming in, knowing my history and seeing where we can go. But I appreciate that. I think that's huge. Yeah. This is major.
I think most people do. And once they really start the patient process and get into it, it's like they realize it's a team approach, right? It's me and the health coach and the nutritionist, and it's all of us coming together to make these decisions for them. And sometimes they've got advanced women's hormones, health issues, and that's where I can turn to my women's health team and say, hey guys, I need help here with these hormones. What are your thoughts? What do you think? What does this patient really need? So it's also that team approach that's just so unique that I can walk next door and talk to my, you know, midwife or women's health obstetric gynecologist provider and say, hey, I need to run this by you. So it's neat.
But this is a great way to actually on-ramp people and then be able to access their insurance for your services.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, that's perfect. I think a lot of people would want to know that part because they can come through you for functional medicine and good health care.
Something else we've recently started pivoting. We actually just hired our first mid-level provider, so a physician assistant that's going to work with our medical director. So we're working on training him. He has some training in functional medicine, but what we're doing is he's coming on and doing all the wellness exam visits for Dr. Holthaus, our medical director. So, and then he'll work under him. So Dr. Holthaus can step forward and really focus on the high level functional medicine. And then he's got a mid-level provider that can do his well exam visits and like his acute visits, right? Somebody comes in with a sore throat or a cough, or they've been exposed to COVID and want to know what to do. So we're piloting that program, and that's something we want to be able to teach and express to other communities and providers what we've learned through that. But it allows us to bring on mid-level providers for those of us who are more experienced in functional medicine, focus on the high level, and then train other individuals to kind of learn what we do and how we approach it.
That's so awesome. I'm excited hearing this because I look at cost too, and I think for not only the patient, but for the government who has to get behind it. And you know, we're looking at the trillions that we throw away into, you know, providing for chronic health care. And, you know, the fact that we spend so much money on all these areas, but are not really truly addressing the heart of the problem. You know, the root disease in everyone that, you know, they're fighting. And instead of addressing it with pharmaceuticals or drugs, I'd rather be able to address it with, you know, something that would help them, you know, really fix the problem, but in a long-term, healthy way. And if it's, addressing their sleep, that might have been the problem versus giving them, you know, this harmful drug that has 39 other side effects.
But maybe they're staying up late at night, eating sugar late at night, and exposing themselves. You know, they're on screens, you know, right up until bedtime. Your brain can't shut down if you're exposing yourself to that blue light right before bed. You cannot make melatonin, which allows you to get that deep, restful sleep, right? You just, your cortisol levels can't come down when you're activating yourself all day. So that's, those are things we teach. We talked about eating hygiene with nutrition, and that's another concept we talked about, sleep hygiene, right? You have to get your body ready to sleep, like your ancestors, right? When we live by candlelight, we didn't have screens and artificial light all day and all night. Our body never knew when to stop making cortisol and start making melatonin so we can rest.
I think that has to be embedded into our education for people today to understand that what they expose themselves to impacts their sleep and overall
and brain
health.
Brain function,
yes.
Absolutely, yeah. So I think the beauty in what we do too, Paulette, is we offer primary care. So that means we're able to use those primary care diagnoses. I can see a patient with high blood pressure, and I can use the hypertension code I'm just treating it a little bit differently than the internist down the street. Yeah. I'm using lifestyle modification as opposed to pharmaceutical agents, at least to start with. And I'm seeing if I can get that patient where I need them there.
Yes.
Of course, sometimes we have to use the pharmaceuticals if and when is needed. But that's also the beauty of me being trained in conventional medicine. Mm-hmm. I know how to merge those two worlds. Yeah. I know when I need to use like the conventional approach because I've practiced it. And I did it for 8 years before I came into functional medicine.
That's beautiful.
But I also know we're failing within chronic disease. I know where our majority of our medical dollars are going, managing chronic disease, and we are failing in the management of chronic disease. I'm thankful we have it for acute emergency healthcare. I'm thankful if my little boy breaks his legs and needs surgery, I know a really good orthopedic surgeon that can fix him. I'm thankful for that. But that's not, you know more than any of us, that's not where the majority of our healthcare dollars are going.
Mm-hmm. So. Right. Yeah, I think that's perfect, and I'm just excited about your facility and you.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, more of you.
There's a whole team of us. We've got 11 practitioners here, so we're a team that's trying to do it together. So we'll head this way. So we've got a group education room here at our Meridian location and also in Boise. But this is really where we focus on our group education. And we bring groups of sometimes 20 to 30 patients together and we educate on cardiovascular health and men's health. Dr. Holhouse, our medical director, did a group talk about 2 weeks ago on intermittent fasting and how just starting to shorten your eating window can improve insulin resistance, heal diabetes, decrease inflammation, encourage weight loss, improve cognition. Mm-hmm. So we have big, large rooms that are dedicated to that kind of group education. So instead of me discussing how intermittent fasting can improve this patient's pre-diabetes and me saying that 2 times a day for months on end, I can say, hey, I've got a medical director who's nationally recognized on teaching this topic and I want you to listen to him next Thursday night at 5:30 and listen to him give his spiel and explain the data behind it and then have a Q&A at the end of the day. It's really efficient care and the patients love it.
Yeah, what I love about what you just said is the Cleveland, well, first of all, you said community care.
Right.
And what I learned, and of course within my own culture too, why it's so relevant and what draws me here is our belief is community heals when it heals and comes together.
Comes together.
And the Cleveland Clinic actually collected data, did all these studies, and found the same thing, that when a community
outcomes
comes together,
overall better.
So I think that's perfect.
Yeah.
And I'm sure you're seeing results already.
Oh, it's incredible. It's incredible. I had a patient that attended a group visit, this was last year, attended a group visit on blood pressure management on a Thursday evening, and I was on call that weekend, and I got a call Friday night saying that she was feeling dizzy and lightheaded and just not feeling well. Mm-hmm. Sure enough, I had to run to urgent care to get her blood pressure checked. It had dropped both systolically and diastolically 20 points. It had already worked within 24 hours of her implementing some of the things she learned within the group education. It was incredible. So we were able to decrease her blood pressure med and within the next couple of weeks get her off of it.
Mm, that's really
neat. Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah.